IVM.
$100. That's all it takes to begin your journey with Bitcoin and Ethereum. No, really. With CoinSwitch, you can start investing in over 100 cryptocurrencies with just 100 rupees. On top of that, there are zero charges for deposits and withdrawals, so you can trade, buy, sell, however and whenever you want. All of this, plus their extremely intuitive interface, makes CoinSwitch the perfect app for beginners in the crypto space. But don't take my word for it. Just download CoinSwitch for free and try it out for yourself. If you'd like more information on cryptocurrencies, tune into A Show About Crypto with me, Rohan Joshi, my new adventure on IVM Podcasts. CoinSwitch. Kuch to badlega.
Here's a question for you. Are you more envious of A, somebody who's more similar to you in most respects but is slightly more wealthier, let's say 50% more wealthier, or B, are you envious of, let's say, some guy like Jeff Bezos or Bill Gates? Is a beggar jealous of a slightly more successful beggar than of Bill Gates? The answer is always the former. Okay, now that is really, really odd because it doesn't make any rational sense, but this is where the subject of jealousy actually comes in. And that is the subject for today's Smarter With Sid. So today's topic is jealousy good for you? Right. Now that's something which has made me kind of stop in my tracks because this thought hit me and I said, I have to share it with you guys. Okay. A little bit on Smarter With Sid is that Smarter With Sid is going to explore different kinds of human emotions and aspects that allow us to become slightly, more evolved in the way in which we respond to situations, context, and people. And one of the most important things is to actually ruminate over thoughts like this, which can kind of make us think twice or have a different perspective over weekend. So anytime a thought like this comes to my mind, I'm going to certainly share it with you. And perhaps on a Thursday where, when you're winding down for the weekend rather than on a Tuesday. Smarter With Sid is going to help you as well as me, because when I'm going through a topic like is jealousy good for you and being jealous actually evolutionarily perfect, then I'm going to learn as well. So we're all in it together. We're getting smarter together. But let me introduce this topic to you in a more sensible way, right? So when I was looking at all these self-help books, right, I just see a common pattern, besides the Follow Your Passion, which is a different rant that will happen on some other day. It is always about focusing on lofty pursuits, but they're always also saying, don't compare yourself to other people, build your own, metrics and marks and stuff like that. And, focus on loftier thoughts and stuff like that, and don't be jealous. But, there's a sting that we feel, all of us feel, you feel, I feel, everybody, and it was there always in school, in college, in post-graduation or in entrepreneurship or in jobs. Whenever somebody else gets promoted, does better, gets a better grade, there's a sting that we feel. And that sting is, the more I think about it, that sting that we feel, whether you call it jealousy or envy, by the way, jealousy is declared as more of something which is connected to being jealous of somebody's relationship. Like you want to get to that, reproductory mate, but, there's somebody else stealing your thunder. Then, okay. So that's jealousy, and envy is more about contextual resources like finance and the rest of it. But I don't want to really confuse the issue. Jealousy, envy, you can call it whatever you want. There's a sting that we feel, right? Now, the more I think about it, the sting that we feel, I thought was kind of designed. Because if it was not designed, then all of us would be, pursuing lofty pursuits and focusing on wonderful goals that, are altruistic and do not feel mean towards our fellow man and the rest of it. But from an evolutionary perspective, I realized that jealousy is extremely important. Okay. And, jealousy is important because from an evolutionary perspective, you're either trying to get the best possible mate, because that is going to drive your genetic pool forward, or you're going to actually try and compete for the best resources, you know, the best grasslands or the best stock of meat or whatever it is. And those evolutionary purposes are kind of deeply driven inside us, in spite of, you know, all of our wonderful rational, logical arguments. In fact, a lot of jealous and envious people mask their envy and jealousy in a lot of logic and reason. Like, I'm not saying that, you know, he's not good, but I did not like that. You know, all of us have done it. But I want to praise jealousy a little, because in fact, I'm involved with a startup, a student-based startup that is focusing on gamifying the workplace. Now, when we are discussing this, and I'm one of the angel investors and also somebody who's conceptualizing the idea, when we were kind of thinking about it, what we realized was that gamification can be looked upon as, ooh, but you're trivializing work, or, ooh, you know, work is something which should not be gamified, because then you're, you know, addressing the lower motifs and all of that. But the fact is that gamification of anything almost always helps improve the results if done well. Now, obviously, whenever you're gamifying something like work, you are playing into emotions such as competitiveness or jealousy or whatever it is. And I think it's high time that we accept it, that it's designed in us, and we need to kind of make better use of it. So what are the advantages of jealousy? One of the advantages of jealousy is certainly it motivates you to do better. If you see some classmate of yours in school get suddenly good marks in Hindi or whatever it is, you feel upset enough to start studying. And that's motivation for you. If are also kind of inspired, because you see that, arre, isko itne marks mile, you know, this guy got, you know, such fantastic percentages, or this guy got such a great promotion, or this guy's got a great job, maybe even I can do it. Now that's inspiration for you. And that is very odd, because motivation and inspiration are coming out of what we call as a negative feeling. But how do you use jealousy well? I think that therein lies the rub, right? Because we tend to not use jealousy well, because we stay in the feeling. We stay in the feeling of being jealous, and then we start attributing all sorts of negative things to that person who is successful, more successful than us, or we start kind of explaining away the rationale as to why they're successful, and none of them are useful. Actually, what is useful is to recognize jealousy for what it is, recognize it for the motivation and inspiration that it provides you, and perhaps do a little benchmarking, saying, whom should I be jealous of today? You know, that's a good question to have. And then you suddenly go beyond your next door neighbor and start modeling against some answers. Like, for example, if I look at, okay, so whom should I be jealous of today? I would certainly say Professor Scott Galloway is, doing really well for himself. He's, teaching at wonderful places. He's a great consultant. He's running fantastic podcasts and all of that. You know, the Prof G Show, Pivot, etc. Now, there are two ways in which I can do it. I can look at it from a very negative perspective. I can say, hey, you know what? He is in the US, and of course he's networked, and he's got lucky breaks and all of that. And, you know, that explains his success. Or I can say, hey, you know what? Obviously, this guy is a bright spark. He's doing something well. And maybe I can look at how to get inspired and motivated by somebody like him to do my work better. Now, that is modeled, right? Now, I'm not saying, okay, I'm going to model after him for the rest of my life. But right now, it serves as a good benchmark. And certainly better than the neighborhood professor that I can bump into each and every day, and who's, got a different set of instincts which I don't necessarily connect to. The core aspect is to benchmark against some really aspirational people, and not stay in the feeling. And of course, you know, the benchmarking is also something which you need to kind of be very wary of. Because I heard on a Jordan Peterson podcast once that, you know, as a clinical psychologist, Jordan Peterson was treating somebody who was very successful, you know, doing really well, man, for himself. But he was depressed because based upon his classmate, he was doing really badly. And then Jordan Peterson found out who this guy was, and it was Elon Musk. Yeah. So obviously, based on that poor benchmate's predicament, Jordan Peterson said that is an unfair comparison. But at least thank God for that. Most of our benchmates are not Elon Musk's. It reminds me, I played under 15 against Sachin Tendulkar, a match against Sachin Tendulkar, and I was just in awe of his talent. Sometimes you understand that, wow, this guy is just something completely out of this world. And I don't think that you can remain jealous if you allow yourself to start admiring and benchmarking. I guess that kind of covers up my treatise on jealousy and how to use jealousy well. I hope you like this episode of Smarter With Sid. Many more to come from where this came from. Do follow me on Instagram and on LinkedIn, where I'm the traveling professor. And if you like podcasts like these, well, IBM's got a lot of good stuff in store for you. Just check them out.
Hey, it's been another great week on the IBM Podcast Network. On the Edge is the Sledges Cricket Podcast. In the first half, Ashwin is joined by Varun to wrap India's ODI tour of Sri Lanka. In the second half, DJ joins the party to discuss the first T20 international between India and Sri Lanka. If you'd like to hear more about this match, former Indian cricketer Sabah Kareem joins Rajiv Mishra on Khel Niti, and they talk some more about it. Ladies and gentlemen, we're really excited to announce a new show, a show about crypto with Rohan Joshi. He's going to dive deep and demystify all the crypto stuff that we've been hearing about. And let me tell you a little bit more about stuff that's going on the network really quickly. Congratulations to Maru Kinayat, who celebrates 50 episodes of The Note with a discussion on health as a fundamental right. On Paisa Vesa, Anupam talks to Harsha Chetanwala of MyWealthGrow.com. Zarina Punawala is starting a new mini-series on emotional intelligence. Do check out the kickoff episode on the Empowering series. And Simplified talks about semiconductors. Do follow us on social media. We're IBM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. And remember, if you're enjoying this show or any other show for that matter, please do tell a friend. That's really helpful for us. And finally, we would like to thank our sponsors on the network this week. They make this all possible. Thank you very much. Siet, Cred, Global Victoria, Bank of Baroda, Intuit India, Lenovo, and CoinSwitch Kuber. We really appreciate your support. Hi, everybody. Just wanted to ask everyone for a quick favor. We're running a brand survey right now and would really appreciate it if you could let us know what you think about the advertising on IBM. Go to ivmpodcast.com/survey and do let us know. As part of this, we'll be selecting 10 random participants and sending them some IBM swag. So do fill out those surveys.
Namaste, this is Cyrus Brocha. I am part of the government cancel culture program to remove rubbish off all the different streams available. So what we have is all the collected rubbish we put together on our show. It's called Cyrus Says. It's on IBM Podcast. You have to watch it and listen to it. It's on our app. It's on our website. It's on the YouTube channel. It's on Facebook. There are many different ways. Don't bother me and ask me how. You have to find out. We talk to different personalities. Many of them are known. Some are just people we meet downstairs and invite them up for chai. But the point is, it's fun and it's very therapeutic. So please join in and listen to Cyrus Says.